brothers gonna work it out. Everybody and welcome to Richmond Oval. It's round 11 in the SANFL, and today it's West Adelaide sitting seventh on the ladder against the Eagles, who are fourth. West Adelaide were travelling pretty well. They'd knocked off Port Adelaide and South Adelaide in recent weeks, but last week they went down by 9 points to Sturt. They've fallen to seventh on the ladder. They've also got the third best attack in the competition, with Adam Richardson really firing with 7 goals last week against the Double Blues at full forward. But today, they're up against the best defence in the competition. I hope you can stay with us. We'll be live until 5 as Tim Jennifer joins us. Or should I say, Magpie, you've changed your name by default, Tim. I guess the big story of the week is Gary Hockey at Geelong has changed his name to Whiskers. I'm just thinking about what name, Tim, we could... Could you be a Magpie?
I could be a Magpie. For $200,000, I could be anything you want me to be, honestly. It's amazing circumstances, wasn't it? I know Geelong are in trouble, but really to change your name for a week, I suppose it is, for $200,000, it's quite staggering.
I'm going to promote you just for a moment. Would we call you Mitre Tim?
Mitre Tim. All right, I'll take that on board.
What about Tim Tam?
Tim Tam.
Tim Burr.
Tim Burr.
Or maybe, wearing your Doc Martens. The one I like, I think, will change your name to Triple Tim FM.
That'll do me.
Well, as we go to the Premiership table, Triple Tim, tell us about Port Adelaide, who are in just terrific form.
They are, and of course, Monday they're playing against Norwood, and it's really going to be one of the clashes of the round. Norwood are really starting to find form. They're probably one of the sides that can trouble Port Adelaide, along with, say, West Adelaide, or give them a bit of trouble, but really Norwood and Port, they're the two teams I can see just striving towards the finals now. Glenelg in second position, they've done very well, I think, and Tony McGuinness will be happy with his charges down there. But today, you've got to look at Westies. They've got to keep in touch with the five, and the Eagles, they want to keep in touch with the top three. So it's a valuable game for both top sides.
Well, it's a real roadblock, isn't it, between seventh and second. The Eagles came out of the bye sitting in second. They lost to Glenelg last week and dropped to fourth.
Yeah, well, that really did cost them, didn't it? And they were 4 goals up at half-time. And then to have Sturt kick 9 goals in the third quarter against them was absolutely damaging. And in the end, that was the best result for Sturt. That's what got them over the line.
As we go to the goal kickers, we had a chance of seeing Adam Richardson last week against Sturt for West Adelaide. He kicked 7 to be 1 goal behind Julian Burton.
Yeah, Julian Burton had a day off, didn't he? 1 goal, 4, and we saw all of those. And Adam Richardson was in superb form at full forward, kicking 7. Him and I thought Timmy Symes were outstanding for West Adelaide last week. They'll be important again today.
Tim, back in round 2, where the Eagles knocked off West Adelaide at Woodville Oval. 30 points was the margin, and I guess a lot of people thought pre-season that the Eagles might struggle, perhaps be at the lower end, but that was perhaps the win against last year's side that finished third that really signalled that maybe they had some talent.
It's a good young side, the Eagles, they really are. I think that what Mark Micken has done with them, he's just let them breathe, let their natural talent and their flair come out, and it's really come off, it's paid off. They've got some really good young players that have really hit on this year. Adam Pearce in the middle as well, since he's gone there from a back pocket, he just wins touch after touch every week. So he's been outstanding.
As we look at the West Adelaide lineup, Tim, you can't help but think what an impressive bunch of players they've got. They've got some stars on every line.
Yeah, look, West Adelaide, they have, you know, one of the great sayings is they're great looking side on paper. And they are every week, but the thing is you have to convert that into performances. And I think that Timmy Symes, the centre-half back today, whether they line up like that, that'll be debatable, because I thought Symes was outstanding at centre-half forward. So they've got everything, haven't they? Their centre line in Connell, Dempsey and Andrewski, it's as good as anybody in the league. So it's really going to be up to them to put a couple of wins together so that they can charge into the finals. Mick Taylor will be disappointed with last week's performance.
As Michael Parsons joins us, Michael, West Adelaide 3 changes this week. Chubb comes into a halfback flank. Watkins comes in, the ruckman, on the bench after a knee injury, and Clint Keary is back after injury.
Yeah, good to see Ben Watkins getting a game again. He's been going around in the twos for a couple of weeks now. He really does supply West Adelaide with some aggression at the ball, and I'm quite impressed the way he goes about it. But you look at the West Adelaide team, they've got the best goal kicker in the league, so their problems with inconsistency aren't there. So you look a bit further up the ground into the midfield, where you see people like Bruin, who's getting a lot of the ball and has been excellent. But as you pointed out earlier, David, the second worst defence in the league, and they'll be under pressure again today if they're going to get a victory.
Interesting stat that, Tim, isn't it? The second worst defence against the league's best defence.
Yeah. Surprising, I thought, because West's defence last week, besides that third quarter, I thought were pretty good, and especially the first half, they ran it out well. So I suppose over the whole season, you really do have to just be consistent.
I guess Port Adelaide sitting on top, you've got to expect that they'd have the best attack. West Adelaide sitting seventh with the third best attack, but then perhaps their defence really is letting down their forwards, or is it vice versa? Is the ball coming out of their forward line?
Exactly. I mean, you do got to chase out of the forward line, and your midfield really has to put the pressure on, which causes mistakes and gets turnovers for him. So I think maybe overall they have to have a look at each end of the ground.
Let's have a look at the Eagles, particularly their defensive zone, Tim. I think that's the area where they set the game up.
They do, don't they? They've got an excellent defence. It's probably got their most experience back there in Rogers and Hall. They really do play well. But Floriani's been excellent off the half-back flank. We saw Fruin do a great job on White when they played against Sturt at Woodville Oval. But it's their centre line is again playing well, so that's going to be a good clash today with Westie's centre line, as well as their forward line. Philip, who I saw kick five goals against Port Adelaide, was outstanding.
Mark Daly joins us. Welcome, Mark. We've talked about Pavlich and Kluzek, a couple of young guns with plenty of talent in the Eagle forward line.
Yes, Dave, just look at that side there. I mean, they've lost a couple of players since last week with Harvey and also Holland missing from last week's side, but coming into a couple of good players here in Wiggins and also James, but their form hasn't been that good over the last month. They played Port back in round 7, they got beaten. They beat North, but everybody's beating North at the moment. They had a bye, and they lost last week to the Bays down at Glenelg. So their form hasn't been sensational, but they're a good side on paper. Just look at that side. I mean, they've got a lot of state players in that team that have played football. You know, Biglands and Hall and also Pearce and Pavlik all play state football. And really, I expect today's game to be sensational.
Thank you, Mark. Colville also a state player, Tim. And there we go again on paper as the toss about to take effect. Greg Mellor for West Adelaide. And Andrew Rogers for the Eagles.
Interesting, Greg Mellor, he's got 24 goals this season, only 3 goals behind the leading goal kicker. I mean, that's a fair performance, isn't it?
Well, I've talked about him before. He's one of my favourite players, a quality player. Andrew Rogers wins the toss and kicks to the right of screen. So we might go back down to Michael Passes. Michael, there is a breeze blowing at Richmond Oval, but very difficult to read.
Mate, your description is a breeze, small hurricane is the way I term it, and the Weather Bureau says it's going to get stronger. When I was a boy, we used to climb mountains in New Zealand. When they said, when you see hogbacks in the clouds, mate, it's time to get off the mountain. I reckon I saw them this morning. There's a strong wind warning out, rain forecast later on. It's a shocking day to be sitting on the boundary line. I might come up and sit next to you in a little while.
I don't think there's any room up here. Red Biglands on screen, Tim. An exciting player for the Eagles, really developing into the potential that the Eagles have seen in him and Port Power for a number of years.
Yeah, excellent. He's had a lot of trouble with injuries as a young man, but now he's 21 years of age. He's starting to shed that off, starting to really develop as a player. Him, Colville and Sigalella as a first ruck is a fair combination.
Mark Naylor, a young 17-year-old playing only his third game for West Adelaide, his fourth game today for West Adelaide, is Malcolm Greenwood, a 17-year-old from the Riverland, and he looks the goods.
Yes, pretty impressive last week I was of young Malcolm Greenwood, a name I think you need to stick into your head for a little while, because I think he's got a lot of potential to go on and play at a higher level. But this side, I mean, the West Adelaide side, they were beaten last week by a very determined double blues unit at Ungerley Oval. Today, I just expect playing at home in front of their home crowd. It's a reasonable crowd here, just considering how cold it is here at Richmond Oval. But I just expect this side to come out full of steam.
And there's the Eagles huddle. Jeff Wiggins, number 38, Tim. I guess if there's one player that the Eagles would have loved to have had back early in the season, it's Wiggins, last year's state ruckman. The leading knock ruckman in the competition last year, but depleted with a knee injury pre-season. He's only just back for his first game for the year.
Well, it's going to be a blessing for the Eagles, isn't it? They've got Biglands in great form, going to have Wiggins working with him off the bench. I think it's going to be an embarrassment of riches, really.
Michael Parsons, you're our rucking expert today. Tim Symes in the middle of the screen. Watkins just walking off the oval. Looks like he's coming to the bench. I guess the big man battles today will go a long way in determining the match.
Yes, David, I wouldn't be go too far out. I think if they said probably the four best big guys in the competition at the moment, you could see them going around today. All four guys, two on each team, have got some real class about them. The guy on screen now, as I said, really does supply some aggression at the ball and really did improve over last year. But it's great to see Wiggins back for the Eagles as well. He's played five games now in the reserves, which is a few more than I thought it would take him to crack a senior game. But as you say, Biglands has been holding down that position so effectively.
Middle of screen just a moment ago, we had Clint Keary. Number five, of course, is Mark Stewart. Another big fellow, Tim. And West Adelaide really probably have the five best big men in the competition.
Well, Mark Stewart's going to have his hands full today with Biglands and Wiggins. I think, like you said, I think that may be the tip of which midfield gets on top. And if you've got to keep your forward line open today too. If you're kicking with the breeze, it's easy to everybody run down there and crowd it up. Got to keep it open, and it'll be interesting to see how both sides handle that today.
Mark Daly, I guess this match, really all the hype coming into it, match of the day, seventh versus fourth, but really two sides very evenly matched, and I guess this is a 4-point game for either side.
Yes, definitely. We see one player there in Gavin Colville. We'll play a very important part in today's side for the Eagles, up against Broome there. But as you said, David, a very important game for both sides, and I just expect that this will be pretty hot pretty early. So I would stay tuned to the ABC this afternoon. This game is going to be pretty good.
The umpires, Greg Inge, Tim Slaven and Richard Fox, officiating this afternoon. Stay with us. We are live until 5. This SANFL match of the day on ABC Sport. Your commentator is Mark Naley with Tim Juniper.
Yes, the Eagles kicking right of screen. The Bloods at home this afternoon. The ball will be put down. Big Biglands up against Stewart. Biglands just a little bit too tall, got his hand to the football, comes to ground. Stewart cleans it up quickly, gets the ball moving forward. You just see there with the breeze. DeRosa comes up with the football, dodges around one or two players, ends up with Barrett. The kick's not good going towards Richardson. He pushes the player away, left leg around his body. It's the first major kicked against the breeze. Great start for the Bloods, Tim.
Well, into the breeze, you've got to be happy with that. I think if you can kick two or three would be an outstanding quarter into this very strong breeze here today at Richmond. And that's a great start to West Adelaide. Some great work in the middle here. Stewart got it out of the centre clearance. Barrett gets it onto his boot. Now, this is great skill for a big man. Gets down low, gets rid of the tackle, snaps around his shoulder. And very good work to Adam Richardson, and doesn't ruin his great goal-scoring record this year.
Back in the middle, see Richardson there, the first major, up against Stephen Hall this afternoon. Biglands again gets his hand to the football in the middle of the ground, then pounces upon little Dempsey. Made sure the ball didn't come clear. Just seeing up forward, Tim, just a couple of matchups. We might pick them up for both sides. As the game would be around about 20 players around this ball at the moment. Colville tries to thump it in his direction, finally gets his hand to the football. Coming out wide now, chance for the Eagles to go forward. Pierce, quick hands, he goes back, comes to Shirley. Shirley heads towards Pavlik at centre-half forward, couldn't take it. DeRosa overruns it, good tackling to keep the ball in the area. Good work in tight. 18 in there is McGregor, can't get near the football. And the umpire will come in and ball up.
Just Rhett Biglands getting his hand to the football, but the other guys are just standing out a bit too wide. His Rovers and his Ruck Rovers are just a bit wide. Need to get a bit closer.
What colour that bloke have? I think it's the Brisbane Bears, the Brisbane Lions.
Yes, he's a Brisbane man, long way from home, but footy fans, Mark, are footy fans wherever they are. Well done, Ed Richardson. Good bustling work. Gets the kick wide to the defensive halfback flank. Jumping in on top of that one, getting away with it was Jason James. Gets away the handball. Filippo fights hard for it. DeRosa over the top of him. And the Eagles try and fly it out, but Matty Connell gathers it in and claimed in the final tackle.
How much pressure is on Matty Connell at the moment? He's taking a fair, not abuse, but he really is under the spotlight at the moment, Tim.
Last week, Darryl Hart watched him all game and probably would have been reasonably impressed with him finding the football, but a couple of times he ran himself back into trouble. He wouldn't have been pleased with that.
Michael Parsons will bring us up to date shortly with the benches for both sides as DeRosa gets the kick forward. Greenwood, Colville, slick hands, Pierce. What clever work to Floriani. Around the corner, it's coming in quickly, but dropping back Sam Jones, a former Eagle player and St Kilda player, and he's found a niche with West Adelaide.
He goes wide out towards Dempsey. Dempsey takes it, quickly gets the ball moving up forward to DeRosa. DeRosa, the kick's not good, but finds his target. 55 there is Greenwood. Over to Connell. Now Connell kicks the ball high. This will sit. Hard ball for Biglands to take. He takes it. So a bit of confidence there with Biglands taking the first mark of the afternoon. Biglands heads towards Pavlik at centre-half forward. The ball's going over the top. Quickly there is Dillon. heads up towards, looks like Filippo up forward. Now, chance here for the Eagles. Quick hands. Filippo's first for the afternoon, and the Eagles bite back.
Some very unselfish play there from Christopher Kluzek to get that to Filippo to kick the goal. He could have ran in himself, so that was unselfish. But the Eagles have kept the forward line open. You see here there's plenty of space, plenty of gaps to run into. So that's going to be the key for any side kicking with the breeze today, to try and keep it open. Very unselfish play.
Bit of strength, Tim, by Kluzek as well. You won't see Gavin McMahon pushed off a ball too often.
And he's a solid unit, isn't he, McMahon? And we saw him on the halfback flank last week do a pretty reasonable job.
One goal apiece. We're just on 4 minutes into the first term. Hope you're enjoying this as Biglin's in ruck for the Eagles. Opposed to him, Stewart thumps it down. Grinnick for the Eagles. Well, it's great to have him back in an Eagle jumper. He's just missed so much football, Tim. I think he's missed something like 2.5 seasons in the last five.
Well, both him and his brother suffer from a lot of injuries, don't they? Both exceptional players, very, very quick. And maybe that's what it is, mate. They were too quick, done too many hamstrings.
Well, we didn't get a chance to give our tips before the start of the game there, David. Just who are you going for this afternoon?
Well, I'm an Eagle fan, as you know. And I think West Adelaide, after last week's drubbing over Sturt, might just hold the advantage.
Yeah, and Jim? I'll go for Westies. I like Timmy Symes at centre-half forward. He was named centre-half back, but he's lined up there at centre-half forward. And I think they've just got to hang on to it.
As we go down to Michael Parsons, he's got the benches for both teams.
We do for sure. Brereton, Watkins and Carey for West Adelaide. The Zanos, Wiggins and Shane Young for the Eagles are sitting down early. And fellas, I'll go the other way. I reckon the Eagles might just get up at the end of the day.
Walk us through this ruck contest, Michael, if you would.
Well, it really gets down to reading the ball best against that strong wind. It really is going to play havoc with the big fellas all day, I would say.
You've had a chance, Michael, to have a look at Biglin's during the year and Mark Stewart. Who do you fancy as the more complete ruckman?
Oh, I think Biglin's is turning into a complete footballer. He had some great games under his belt before he got a horrendous injury, and that really slowed him down for a couple of years. But now he's really starting to find some form, and I wouldn't be surprised to see him playing at the next level up, probably next year even.
Yes, it's a good call there. I've been quite impressed with what I've seen of Biglin's and also Stewart this year. He's very mobile for a big man. I think we've said that quite a few times over the last couple of years. The players are going on and playing at a high level. Comes back the broom here. Going for the safety of the boundary line. It's out of bounds on the full just quickly there.
Particularly, Tim, when you see guys like Simon Eastow, who went from Norwood to Western and really made the grade.
Absolutely. I think still the old adage that the bigger the player, the longer it takes for them to mature. And I think that really will play into a couple of these guys' hands.
That breeze is strong. We just noticed the ball did hold up in the air. Back to Dempsey. He'll be taken by Ugrinic. That's holding the ball, umpire. He agrees with me. That's good to see. Good start, umpire.
Yes, umpire Timmy Slaven. Does a good job.
Ugrinic heads towards centre-half forward. It's a good kick. Up over the back, ringing the ball well. Number 11 for the Bloods is Miles. He's got a chance here to set up Connell. Connell goes for one bounce. Heads up towards Mellor from behind. Couldn't take it. Comes out loose now. They're still keeping it in the area. Mellor again couldn't take it. The Eagles have numbers in there. Pierce could overrun the football. Back to Greenwood. He couldn't get it. Gives it back to Greenwood. Greenwood goes around his body. Connell has covered some ground here. Richardson comes out again unselfishly. Gives the handball. Ball centred, comes towards Tim Symes. The Symes will be taken. The handball wasn't good, but Dempsey's there. Now we'll set it up. He goes over the top, trying to find Greenwood. Has he the pace? I think he has, but good tackle by Rogers. At ground level now is Biglin's forcing the ball forward, and Colville should take this. He goes for the soccer off the ground. Intelligent work there by Gavin Colville. Unfortunately, the ball hasn't gone out.
Chubb brings it back inboard, and Symes marks. Gee, Tim, I can't remember how closely DeRosa and Greenwood look alike. Symes. Oh, this will be dangerous. The kick will need to work, and it did. DeRosa made it work. I think originally the target was Bannick, but the kick was too long, and DeRosa read it beautifully. Three kicks, and they haven't advanced 5 metres down the ground, West Adelaide, as Broome has the ball inside the 50. Great congestion. The Eagles have worked back hard to get into defence. West Adelaide have got no leading area for Richardson to move into, so Stewart now marks 60 metres out. Mark Stewart, the big West Adelaide ruckman, looks for the lead, and that kick is a shocker. It's not worked at all for him. being tackled and going to ground was, looks like Jason James, and it was Greenwood who got him. No, it was Sikkelela, and Greenwood got him, the opposition rover.
Today, gentlemen, with a breeze like this, you really have to watch your skills. You have to punch the ball into the breeze very strong and just got to be very, very careful with the skill level because you can turn the ball over very easily.
Biggins gets it down. Dempsey's in quick, takes it, then tackled high. He wasn't paid the free kick. Again, we'll see the umpire come in. Pretty determined look there on Biggins' face. And the supporters here this afternoon rugged up, scarves over their head that keep their ears nice and warm. Conditions, well, it is winter, fellas. We've got to expect cold days.
Good crowd, though, Mark.
Yes, they're still coming in. I was a bit worried there about 2 o'clock before the start of the game, but numbers really have, well, have come out to support their local SANFL side.
Could be a chance of frostbite today. Very chilly.
9.5 minutes in at the bounce. Biglands throws it down the throat to Floriani. Couldn't quite take control. Pierce battles hard for it, but Robbie Lee for West Adelaide, wearing the helmet, he's fighting pretty hard too. So you can just sense the desperation, Tim, by both sides.
I just got the feeling that Westies, like you said, would have got a real rev up from Mick Taylor this week and said, you know, besides getting a good start, we've got to go on with it. And I think it would have had them really fired up for the beginning of this contest anyway.
The Bloods 24 points up at half-time against Sturt last week. Lost it by 9. I think Michael Taylor would have been shattered. Greenwood threw that one out. Floriani belted it onto the boot but didn't get much distance in the kick. Robbie Lee goes hard at it, but Floriani claims him and calls for the free kick. And the umpire says, fellas, I'll have a bounce. We're 10 minutes in to the first quarter at Richmond Oval. We hope you're enjoying this throughout South Australia and the Northern Territory on ABC Sport.
Well, good start by West Adelaide at the moment. They're kicking into a, I'd have to say, what, a 4 or 5 goal breeze up here.
Strong.
We may get Michael Parsons just to give his impression at ground level, but the ball's been kicked clear. Chance here for Eagles to get the ball moving forward. Good pickup. Looks like Fruin.
James.
It was James running hard out wide. Heads towards Christopher Kluzak.
What about the new hairstyle, Tim?
Well, there looks like there's been a bit of bleach sold down at Woodville Oval lately. Rhett Biggins has got a bit of a tinge in the hair, and vote. Chris Kluzak's got the lock.
Vote catches.
It wouldn't happen in our day, would it?
Well, I remember a young Mark Naley with some tips at one point.
Oh, yes. They're grey tips, David. It's our ongoing these days. Broome forward. DeRosa goes back with the football.
North 32. And Sturt, was that no score? Is that correct, that score? Well, well.
Start by the Roosters, that's good.
Well, you can't pick them, can you? They were 10 goals down at halftime last week.
Well, might be going with a strong breeze.
Up forward again. Good knock over the top there. Gives a chance for Andruski. Couldn't clean it up quickly. Working back hard there is Dylan. Heading for the boundary line. Great work by Robbie Lee. Andruski, left leg, heads towards the goal square. And that's Fruin's quite content to see the ball push through for a rush behind. So 1-1-7 plays the Eagles. Just a one solitary goal. So a point difference here at Richmond Oval.
I think Mick Taylor will be happy with West Adelaide. They've had most of the attack. And that kick-out's gone straight down the throat of Matthew Broome.
Broome worked himself in a position pretty well. That is a strong breeze. He sat right at the back where he should. Richardson, front position. Couldn't quite take it. Shirley gets through traffic, dispatches the handball forward. McCarthy got a good shepherd by Pearson. Just created enough space. The former Tasmanian coach pushes the ball forward. Bannock underneath it. Well, just bustled off it. This is Whelan. Oh, taken high in the Northern Territory. There's a few blokes up in Darwin who know this fellow, and he goes pretty tough, Tim. And I don't think you'll mind that. That's just a gentle tap for him.
He didn't even flinch.
Well, they don't from up there. They are tough. Chubb. Doug Thomas expecting him to be drafted next year. Well, doesn't he lose some players, Doug? And over the top of that ball, fighting hard, Ken McGregor. And I think Ed Richardson's got his hands full today as we go to the Eagle bench. Bit of height, bit of pace.
Bit of everything on that bench, isn't there? Darzanos, we saw a few weeks ago. He's got a bit of talent about him. He's just got to get rid of that ball a bit quicker.
Stewart comes up with the football, goes to DeRosa. DeRosa over the top there. Finally ends up with Connell. Gaines around his body. The kick, quick kick forward. Can't find his target, but Greenwood's over the top. Good work by Greenwood, trying to find his captain in Mellor. Again, some hard work done out there. Symes working overtime to keep the ball in the area. It's a chance here for the Bloods. Barrett couldn't take it again. Big Richardson comes out. He'll head for the top of the goal square. He goes in that direction. Good work. A bit of shepherding from behind. The umpires let the game flow. Floriani comes up with it and kicks wide.
Good work, Matty Connell, to come back on it. Flips it forward in the double play and then drives it long towards full forward. Greenwood has the sit in it. Rogers, the veteran, closes in on him. But here comes Greg Mellor. What a quality player he is. Gets out the handball. Greenwood, very clever. But look at the reading. Pierce, slick to Colville. Out the back door, it's Rogers. Then the skipper just paddles it forward. What experience he's got. Give the young legs of Ugrinic a run. And Ugrinic goes along the boundary line. The ball sits nicely for him. Handball over the top was the right option. Dillon fakes on a ruckman. Well, you do that every time, wouldn't you? And takes off with a couple of bounces inside 50. Long to goal, but the kick was disappointing.
It's going to be difficult coming from this side pocket, kicking into the breeze. You've got to set it up probably to the top of the square because it's almost going to be impossible with that breeze blowing it across. So Dillon did some great work there to get around the big ruckman, but just should have finished off a little better.
The ball to be brought back in. We've played 14 and a half minutes of this first quarter. The scores are locked away at 7 apiece. Chance here. Dion Miles just chips the kick forward. Finds Connell. Back again to Miles. A quick handball here to DeRosa. DeRosa through the middle of the ground looking for Barrett. Barrett couldn't take it. In there hard as Lee again. Tackled hard there by Colville. Back to Barrett. Back to DeRosa. He sets up Broome in the middle of the ground. Broome quickly turns. Kicks left leg. Up four. What a mark by Mellor.
There's a lot to like about this bloke, Tim.
That is a great grab too, isn't it? Because Rogers is a great defender. He's just sat that up and basically stopped it with the one hand and then pulled it into his chest. Great grab, and he's so fierce. That's what I like about him. He's a forward, and he's just so fierce with it.
Well, Greg Mellor would only be kicking for about 45 metres. I'll tell you now, fellas, it won't reach the goal square. That's how strong this breeze is this afternoon. We'll sit and watch.
He's a powerful kick.
It's not too often that I'm wrong. It kicks on its way. I'm wrong this time because he's brought it home. Has he the direction? I don't think he has. One finger goes up. So behind to the Bloods. What a start by they. Wow, this side, they're 1-2-8. The Eagles just 1-1-7.
We're a fair way into this first quarter, 15 and a half minutes, and you've got to be very, very happy with West Adelaide at the moment. They've got a lot of the play, and the Eagles just haven't managed to use the wind properly yet.
Floriani holding decision. McGregor, who's playing at centre-half forward, will take the benefit. Shepherd it out of the contest, said the umpire. You talk about exciting players. This fellow's one of them. High quality, high leaper and good hands, and so is this fellow, Pavlich. Marks looks to play on quickly. Here comes a lead from Kluzik. It's a beautiful kick. Oh, well done, DeRosa. That was lay-down Mazier for Kluzik. He would have just marked and kicked for goal. And DeRosa made good yardage to get there. Stimes wide to O'Connell. Defence into attack. And how quickly you can turn it over and West Adelaide go forward. This is Richardson playing as a defender. Running hard. He's deep in attack. Connell a high ball. Mellor sits underneath this one. Well done, Andrew Rogers. The skipper punched it down. And Sicilella thumps it out to McCarthy. Broome's got him. McCarthy got the handball away. Rogers with a rear fumble. Mellor comes after him. And the skipper goes to ground. And Mellor and Dempsey wrap him up.
Westies, look at this attack on the ball. Look at this, bang. That's fantastic. That's courage by both players. And DeRosa just smashed through it. But West Adelaide's skill level at the moment into the breeze is far superior.
Biglands will take this, gets his hand the football. Couldn't find his target. Broome's in there quickly. Again, the big fella in Biglands rows his own ruckwork, kicks the ball towards the centre of the ground. And the wind's taken this. It's over the top. A chance through Andriski. He's out wide. The left leg, that's where he likes it. Puts it up for Barrett. Now Barrett outside 50, has movement from Connell. He's working up and down the ground. Good work by Matthew Connell to take this ball inside 50.
Yeah, this is a tough kick, Mark. This is a real tough one.
I think he needs to aim, I think. I would come, I reckon, about 10 metres this side of the point post.
He kicks this, he's a genius.
He's getting plenty of the football. He's had 7 kicks already. It's a good kick up forward. Richardson gets one hand the football. Couldn't take it at the ground level. Is skill. Dempsey. And Dempsey's over the top. It's a major. That's his first. And that's the West Adelaide's second.
Well, Mark, just before Connell kicked that, I was going to say probably go to the top of square would be a better option. As it turned out, that's where the kick ended up going.
I don't think it was intended there, Tim.
No, it wasn't. Symes and Richardson made a contest of it. And look at Dempsey's skill level. Just came off the pack. He hardly even took the ball before he laid it onto his left foot and snapped it. So exceptional work, and West Adelaide, they would be ecstatic with their first quarter. Into the Breeze, already have a lead of 7 points.
18 and a half minutes in, and West Adelaide clearly having the better of the Eagles in this term. McCarthy ruck roving for the Eagles today. Puts in a long one. It's a wobbly one towards Pavlich. Caught under the ball. Kluzek misses it. McMahon goes to the back door and just defends stoutly. Switches the direction of play. Got through. Kluzek almost. Kluzek did well just to hold him up in the final wash. And a kick wide of the mark. Dillon underneath it. And it's a point.
Probably had more time to steady up and just... Sigalella had more time there just to straighten up and really go for a drop punt there rather than just have a lazy snap. They're under pressure, though, and that's the pressure that West Adelaide's put upon them.
Well, Sigalella with the point mark.
And, fellas, you might be interested, down on the boundary line, the first spots of rain for the afternoon starting to fall, but I'm interested in the stat count. It seems like there's a red and black ball out there, and West Adelaide, a great mark taken. West Adelaide own the football right now.
Well, quickly, Michael, where have you seen West Adelaide winning the game at the moment?
They're just controlling the football. Their skill level, as Timmy Jinnah's pointed out, into this Breeze has been fantastic. They have hardly missed a kick all day.
Now, Michael, I said 4 or 5 goals this Breeze would have to be worth this afternoon. What would you say down there at ground level?
Definitely a stronger Breeze than normal. 4 to 5 goals, I would say.
Well, that's not a good start by the Eagles. If that's the case, if Michael Parsons saying at ground level it's worth at least 4, at the moment they are trailing the West Adelaide.
Man up, God's sake. Chris Barrett hit the post and Stephen Hall brings the Eagles out. That's a set play. Shirley short to Florian. And that's the second time this quarter that's worked for them, Tim. So West Adelaide need to have a look at that.
Yeah, I don't know whether you'd be going short though, David. You've got the Breeze.
Go long. Long's not working for him. What a good mark that is. Ed Richardson well down from his regular full-back position. Robbie Lee. Great courage, took the ball, Floriani wrapped him up, Andriski swings around on the left boot, squares it up towards the centre of the field. McCarthy read it beautifully, just experience from the defender. The handball over the top, Hall is in trouble, swings to the boundary. That was a good decision in the final analysis, and out it goes wide. 32, Jason James, work with us, Mark.
I'm just saying, David, the Eagles at the moment, they're just walking around this park. It really is not a committed Eagle side that's out there.
Pierce to Whelan to McGregor. And you're right, Tim. I think the Eagles are playing a little short. They're not using the Breeze at all. And Dion Miles is doing a good job just chopping Pavlich out of the contest. He's had one good mark, but Miles really has rebounded as he did then. Beautiful kick. Symes is playing well across half forward. So West Adelaide have got winners on every line. And, well, look at this. Greg Mellor. And he's beating a quality player in Andrew Rogers. Out by Boo the whistle a little prematurely, but Mellor will take it anyway and play on. Matty Broome was the target. Colville closes in. Gavin Colville holds the ball in, and Richardson, the big full forward, Adam Richardson, just jumps on top of him, gives him a slammer.
Well, Mark Nulley was trying to make the point. There was 4 Eagle players here at one contest in front of the grandstand. Yep. Just walked into the centre of the ground. Did not make an effort to get over to assist or make a play.
Other games being played around the state this afternoon. See the Bulldogs. They're 21. They lead South 13. And North, well, those scores are right. 38 plays. The double blues yet to score. So Sturter in trouble. But it's a fair breeze in the state. Here we see West Adelaide. They're 15. They lead the Eagles. It's a push in the back, I reckon, Tim. Free kick will come to Mellor.
Yeah, no prizes for guessing that one.
Mellor goes wide, looking for DeRosa. Oh, the Brack was through it. He punches the ball down, then takes it. Runs with it, gets the ball forward to Pierce. Pierce, right leg, heads up towards Pavlik. The big frame, he's out front, couldn't take it. This chance he has a time to clean up. He's got a bit of pace for such a big fella, but he is young, 17 years of age. A good kick by Pavlik.
Nice.
It carries the pack. That's his first major. And one needed, I think, for the Eagles. They're 2-2, West Adelaide 2-3.
Well, that's the first time we've really seen the Eagles pick it up and run and go long. You see a good piece of work here. Pavlik picked it up off the ground, just ran and said, I'm going straight to the square. And with this breeze today, it will carry. Jones was having a contest in the square, went over the top of those guys. It was always going to be a goal. But the Eagles want to do a little bit more of that, a bit more direct football, and take advantage of a strong breeze.
2-3 to 2-2, 1 point the margin. The Eagles need another... couple perhaps before quarter time.
Biglin's in ruck. Dead heat that one with Stewart, but clever work. Floriani gets the kick away. Chubb now out of defence. It's Bannock. A long ball forward. Colville fights for it. Robbie Lee goes hard. This fellow's a goer, no question about that. Shirley and Broon, Colville, there'll be sparks flying between those three. They are three players who are very hard at it.
Gavin Colville, exciting young player. Having a good year. Robbie Lee just taking him on there. Plenty of pressure. A little bit of a push there by Broom. The umpire had none of that. See Broom onto the ball quickly. Kicks it up forward. The bounce up in favour of Fruin. Great tackle by Lee. Fruin heads for the boundary line. The ball will be thrown in. Inside 50 for the Bloods once again. Well, 15 times has gone inside 50 for the Bloods. Only 9 to the Eagles. So they really have controlled this quarter of football. Tim Symes in screen. We'll play 24 and a half minutes for 1 point margin. No doubt coach Mark Micken wouldn't be happy with his charges at this stage of the game. Ball thrown in. Biglin's up against Symes. Symes over the back. Try to find Broom. Broom couldn't take it. Well done by Gavin Colville. He'll take it up. The support there running is Rogers. Rogers comes towards the centre of the ground. Now looks for somebody to pass it off to. Out wide is Ugrinic. Going with him will be Bannock, but the ball will beat both players out over the line.
Well, you cannot be happy with that. That's your captain, your most experienced player, coming through the centre of the ground with the breeze, changing tact and coming out to the flank. Suicide stuff.
West Adelaide, Tim, are playing a man loose in defence, and I think that was a problem as we go down to Michael Parsons.
There's one of the things you can notice from down here, fellas, is that the Eagles are pushing back into the back line, but then with the strong breeze, when they come out, they really haven't had an option to go to, and I think that's one of the reasons why they've pushed the ball wide.
Well, Tim, it really has been West Adelaide in that first quarter. For the Eagles, I mean, what are they going to do in that second quarter at the moment? I mean, they are getting beaten in most positions.
Well, unbelievable stuff by West Adelaide. Mick Taylor obviously had them fired up. And the way they started that quarter, they were just hard at it. And their skill level into the breeze was exceptional. Getting it up forward to guys like Richardson and Mellor and Symes, who are all taking grabs and all being targets. Now, Matty Connell this week was superb. Got the ball, was going one direction, didn't turn around, kept going with it. And he's probably had 8 or 9 touches this quarter. An absolutely brilliant quarter from Matty Connell.
Well, quarter times scores here at Richmond Oval. See West Adelaide there, 2 goals, 3, 15. The Eagles, 2 goals, 2, 14. And you're sitting at home, nice and warm, watching it live and exclusive to ABC Sport.
Hope you're enjoying this match throughout South Australia and the Northern Territory. A 1 point ball game at quarter time, but you do suspect that West Adelaide just doing a little bit better into the breeze. One of the exciting things about watching SANFL football is watching young players develop. They come from all parts of the globe. One such fellow was Greg Dempsey, who came from the Riverland, came down to West Adelaide, made a bit of an impact. The Crows picked him up, but unfortunately, injury robbed him of valuable time with the Crows, and finally he was delisted. But now he's back at West Adelaide playing some great football.
I've been with West Adelaide for 4 years. I came down from Remark initially, and Jeff Morris was the man who got me down to Adelaide. I played Remark in the seniors for 3 years, and reasonably successful. We won a premiership the last year I was there, and I think they've struggled since, but are starting to regain a bit of form. It's one of probably 3 premierships I've played in back there, and yeah, I'm hoping to play in one down here at some stage. I spent 2 years on the Crows list and just had a lot of troubles with leg injuries. Yeah, I did gain a lot of positives. There was a few big downfalls with the injuries and whatever, but yeah, certainly a lot of positives came out of it. Mark's been good. He's got a lot of confidence in his players and he backs them up, and I think that's where a bit of success comes. My personal goals this year would be to play consistently at a league level, and obviously at a team level, we'd like to make the top 3 and make a presence felt in the finals and hopefully take out a premiership.
Well done, Greg. Well, they made the top 3 last year, Tim, but they didn't really make their presence felt, did they?
Not in the final analysis, but they definitely improved, and I think they were very happy with perhaps making third, but this year they wanted to go a step further and make that grand final. Greg Dempsey's one of those players that probably get them there.
I thought in the finals they really missed big Adam Richards. They had moderate full forward last year. He's, of course, gone to Fremantle. But when he kicked this goal, it was a classic full forwards goal, swinging around on the left boot, just breaking a tackle and bang.
Well, for the size of him, his agility does surprise you at times, and the big fellow, he really has got it. Look at that around his body quite well, but the way he picked it up and moves, it's quite exceptional.
I talked to you, Tim, before the game about Greg Mallow, and I thought he was one of the real quality players of the competition. I guess when the Eagles give him their skipper in Rogers to pick him up, and he plays the quarter like we saw, it really just underlines how good he is.
Absolutely. Matthew Braun here, he gets plenty of the football, puts it in. Look at this contest. That is a very good grab and very good strength to hold out a player of Andrew Rogers' calibre. Have a look at it again. He just stopped it with his left hand and then pulled it into his chest. Just fabulous stuff.
We saw Greg Dempsey in the player profile at quarter time. I like a lot about him, the way he goes. He's very hard at it. His skills are pretty good and he's not bad around goals.
Well, this is a great piece of work. Matty Connell, who we said found plenty of it that quarter and was excellent, comes to the contest, comes off hands, hardly brings it to boot, and he's got it on and snapped it already. That is a mark of a class player, and it was no fluke. He did that very deliberately. Look at that. Exceptional stuff.
I think it's fair to say, Tim, that Michael Taylor would be pretty happy with the way his boys played into the breeze. We go down to Michael Parsons and the West Adelaide huddle.
Yes, and I think we've got Michael Taylor just talking to his players in the huddle.
The run's good.
We hit our targets, that was the thing. We hit our targets, so that's all right. It's only if we miss our targets over there, we're under a bit of pressure.
With the wind, when we're defending against the wind, we've got to watch the one that carries over. Yeah. 9 times out of 10, it's just the missing of the guard in the back.
I don't know who it was that missed once in the centre, but hey, they're off.
And you'd have to agree with Michael Taylor that West Adelaide have hit their targets and their skills are exceptional in that first quarter, and he's really just looking for them to continue that into the wind in this second quarter, or with the wind, I should say, in this second quarter. Mark Micken, on the other hand, took a long time to come to his players, and the players were exceptionally quiet, very quiet in the huddle from both the players and supporters. Just everybody is standing around really waiting for Mark Micken to arrive. When he did, just talk to them quietly about some structural changes. You'll see a lot of guys just man up, go one-on-one. Brett Biglands will play a kick behind the play, but really looking for them to lift their work rate across the half-forward line and really start to work the ball into this stiff breeze here at Richmond Oval.
And it is a very stiff breeze. We've just been blown away, Tim. My toupee's gone.
I'll tell you what, it's one of those days where if you miss the ball in your hands and it hits you in the nose, you're going to cry for a year. That's what it's like.
You've never cried.
Nah.
Port players don't cry. I just wouldn't believe that for a moment as we look at the quarter time scoreboard here at Richmond Oval. West Adelaide 2-3, kicking into a very stiff breeze. The Eagles are 2-2, a 1-point ball game, but you'd have to say that West Adelaide have the upper hand.
Well, it's going to be important the way they use the breeze in this quarter. They could waste that good effort in the first quarter into it if they don't go direct and keep their forward line open this quarter. So the Eagles didn't use the breeze well, and maybe West can happen as well.
As we go down to Michael Parsons.
Yeah, Mark, with the into the wind this time, what have you got planned for them?
I just got to work a lot harder. We weren't getting anything off hands there from our small players. So we're getting beaten on ball at the early stages. So we just made a couple of structural changes and we'll see how that goes.
Fantastic, right. Mark. Thanks very much.
Thanks to Mark Micken. As Mark Naley walks us through the stats, as you'd expect, West Adelaide had a lot more of the ball.
Yes, Dave, and Mark Micken didn't look too happy there, but you can see why. West Adelaide dominating with the kicks, but that gets down to McConnell, DeRosa and Bruin. They're on ballers. They've had 11 possessions each of those three players. Handballs were clear domination there by the Bloods with 31-17. Marks, well, 17 more with 27-10. I mean, that's just outstanding. Great quarter football by the Bloods.
And in other matches at Adelaide Oval, Central 5-3, South 4-1. That's a progressive score into the first quarter at Adelaide Oval. And at Prospect Oval, North 6-3, Sturt 1 point. North Adelaide used the breeze, we're told, in the first quarter beautifully. Sturt really didn't get their game going. That is a quarter-time score. Stay with us as the second quarter unfolds at Richmond Oval. Your commentator, Mark Naley.
Yes, David, we just see the start of the second quarter. This is going to be very interesting just to see how the Eagles do respond. Stewart thumps the ball forward, comes back to Floriani. Good smother there by Robbie Lee. And it looks like The player in Biggles, just taken a little bit high, receives the free kick. He goes wide out towards Floriani again. With him, going hard with Sharp. The free kick's been played again. Umpire will bring it back to Floriani. We'll just wait now. So a slightly built Floriani kicks the ball up towards centre-half forward. Dempsey there goes up with Richardson. Neither player could take hold of the football. Pavlik's there, Colville's there as well. Good tackle from behind by Dempsey. Quick interchange of handball, ends up with Broome. Now Broome left leg, he'll go long and strong down towards centre-half forward. Back there was Biglands, couldn't take it on his knees. Great work there by Mellor to force the error. Comes back in board again. Colville needs support, he finds it in big Biglands. He needs to get rid of the football now, he does that. Now the great pressure here by the Bloods, just keeping the ball in the area. Comes up again to Robbie Lee. The handball there wasn't that good. Oh, some great desperation shown here by both sides, and ends up now, the umpire will come in, blow his whistle, and we'll ball it up.
Well, I'm just loving the way West Adelaide are crashing into every contest, and the Eagles haven't had an easy possession. Every time they tried to get a kick away, they were tackled.
At the bounce, Biglands, who is doing pretty well in the air, thumps it down. Matty Broome around the corner. It's a scruffy old kick. Mellor claimed around the hips by Rogers. Classic tackle, that one. Ugrinic uses his pace. We love seeing this side in South Australian football. We've just not seen it enough. McGregor thumped away from him by Miles. Now it's Andriski playing a prominent role on the wing today for West Adelaide. And Broome ruck roving, finding plenty of the ball. Possession number 10 for him, and we're only 2 minutes into the second quarter. 22 thumping the ball away as Brent Frewen. And we've seen him, Jim, play some great games for the Eagles in defence.
He has, hasn't he? He's had a pretty good season so far today. And he's going to have his work cut out this quarter, I think.
It's chilly out here, isn't it? Chilly at Richmond Oval.
South Adelaide Rovers, you're pretty soft as well. You don't hear these little Port Adelaide Rovers complaining, Jim?
I'm complaining, believe me, it's all happening.
Disappointed.
15 plays 14. A little chip up. Ooh. It's gone over the top. This is danger signs here for the Eagles. Robbie Lee will go over the top to DeRozan. Now, what can DeRozan do? He's outside 50, gives it off to Matty Connell. Connell won't miss this. He doesn't either. Great goal. Great kick by Matty Connell. That's his first.
Well, that is a great start for West Adelaide with the breeze in this quarter. They set up the game with a great first quarter into the breeze. Now they have to sort of really put the nail in the coffin here. DeRozan has found enough of it to be damaging. Gets it to Connell. Connell's a beautiful kick. Doesn't miss that one, but West Adelaide, I'm very impressed with the way they're going about their football today. I think they're very angry with last week's loss.
We've got to ask the question, who's picking up DeRozan? Who's picking up Matty Connell? Who's picking up Matthew Broome? At the moment, those three players running around, just controlling this game.
I think we might get Michael Passes to earn his money and have a look at the matchups there for us as Biglands thumps the ball down. That one's too high. Chris Barrett takes the free. Little state squad rover. And he goes pretty hard at it. You like the way he goes about his football. Richardson, front position, had the ball thumped away. The Eagles through Rogers, got it from Jason James in the handball. But the kick wasn't really up to scratch. Floriani holds the ball. Sigalella released. The kick is wide, and we're losing everything at Richmond Oval. And here comes
Ugrinic.
It's like a foot race, isn't he? Just takes off like a racehorse. And Pavlik over the top of it. Dillon fights hard for the ball, a tough, scrappy player, but he's met another tough, scrappy player as well as they go to ground.
And well, Mark, sorry, Mark, you asked who was picking up Matty Broome. That was a specific job given to Adam Pearce by coach Mark Mingan at quarter time.
Yes, he needs to be on his mark. See Colville, a player I've watched very closely over the last couple of seasons. Has impressed me. The ball's thrown in. McGregor over the back. Couldn't take it. Good exchange of hands again. Up there again was McGregor. Kicks the ball up forward. Player slipping over there. Chance for the blood through Bannick. Comes up again. Now Dempsey, what will he do with it? Just chips it up and gives his captain a chance to take it. Good work from behind by Andrew Rogers. Again, they can set it up. Goes up. 11 is Christopher Kluzak. He goes to the top of the square. The kick's good. Where's Pavlik? He's there. He jumps and he marks. Oh, this kid is a talent.
Well, Well, just as we mentioned that in the crowd there is two AFL scouts, one Carlton, one Collingwood have been spotted. And there's no doubt they'll be able to look at this bloke. Carlton probably be thinking, maybe we've got another Stephen Kernaghan on our hands here.
Carlton might get him. Collingwood might. Collingwood are down the bottom.
Oh. It's a goal. It's a kick by Matthew Pavlik. That's his second. He kicked one on the first, one on the second now. This is a great start by Matthew Pavlik.
Good work by Kluzak here, putting it in up high. He's about three deep. He comes over the top and takes a great grab. Should have probably been held out of the contest earlier. They allowed him a run at the footy.
Good hang time.
And with his, exactly, with his ability to leap, you don't allow him a run at the ball.
What an important that one that was for the Eagles. They're 3-2, trailing West Adelaide 3-3. 1 point margin as it was at quarter time. Dead heat in ruck. Bruin. McCarthy claims him. Bigland's off the ground. Forces the runners to go at it. This will suit you, Grinning. Sheer pace. He takes off. Has a bounce. Wouldn't you love to see him fit long term? A high ball towards centre forward. Here's Pavic again. Two hands to that ball. Collapsing the pack underneath him. He did pretty well, but couldn't complete it. And Sam Jones comes up with the ball for West Adelaide.
Well, I've got to say that the Eagles are working far harder this quarter than what they did with the Breeze. So they've really got to be able to convert, keep the pressure on Westies.
I've got a big side. You know, he had his hands on the football, did Pavlik, just couldn't bring the ball to ground. You just love watching young talent like him emerge from the SANFL ranks. That's a mark there by Kluzak. Umpire puts two hands in the air, calls play on. He does it again. Kluzak should have been paid. DeRosa comes out, takes it now. He'll settle things down. Get things moving. Well, he hasn't got a centre-half forward at this stage. Timothy Symes now comes in. Decides to go short, does DeRosa, and finds Dempsey.
And now's the time to hit Symes because there's a lot of room up forward.
Symes will go for the mark. We threw it at the back. Good mark. We called it early. That's the play they're looking for. On to Connell. Connell realising the pressure was about to be applied to him. Fairly tight. Umpire calls play on. Hall will take it and clear.
The advantage paid as Hall gives it out to Colville. You talk about quality players. This fellow showed in the state game. He's up to the standard. A wide ball and Pavlic, who was also one of those young players who shone in the wet at the MCG for South Australia, kicking three goals. Over the top he goes. Chris Kluzak caught underneath the ball. Colville toe pokes it forward. A little bit of space created. Kluzak on the boundary line. Well, what is he doing? I thought he was check-siding, but he pushes it up for Filippo. Over the top of it. Filippo gathers it in, looks for a handball, gets one out, and it's smothered.
Great work.
Great desperation by Sam Jones deep in defence as McMahon gets it out to Connell.
Oh, great start. Good working off the ball as well. Bruin just giving Connell a little bit of time, a little bit of space to create something. The kick wasn't good. Wasn't good at all. He finds Biglands.
Hasn't he improved, Mark?
Well, you get a kick laced out there. Oh, Kluzak. This time he takes it. This time the umpire has to pay it.
Haven't the Eagles left it?
Well, they had to. The first quarter was just really disgusting.
I'd love a copy of Mark Mickens' speech at quarter time.
So would I. Floriani kicks it up. The ball hasn't carried. Reading it. Going back with it was Jones.
What about Ed Richardson?
Jones's efforts in the square last contest down there with Filippo and then swung him around and then smothered it.
I reckon they're combining pretty well, Jones and Richardson. Richardson just shepherded Jones then. They're the things that don't show in the stats. The coach loves them. Pierce, Mrs. McCarthy, that was the target. Well done, Whelan. Kicks and punches. Bang, goes hard. Pierce and over the top of this, it's Dillon. We'll get a chance, Tim, to see how strong this breeze is.
Well, Jason Dillon is a very strong kick, so I don't think he'll have any trouble making the distance. Probably just the accuracy into this stiff breeze.
Do you play much footy with him?
Yeah, a fair bit, yeah.
Tell us about his strengths.
Oh, he's got one of those vertical leaps that you dream of. No, that's not a good kick.
So is kicking a weakness or is that generally a strength?
He's a good kick normally, but I knew he'd make the distance, but I was just worried about the stiff breeze. He didn't actually get onto that. As you can see, it wasn't a drop punt at all. It ended up being a helicopter and didn't get much penetration, but the Eagles have lifted, but Mark, both midfields are playing off one another.
Yes, they are playing well. And down the boundary line, Michael Parsons
Yes, Mark, we talked about some of the midfield matchups before, and I think I might have sold a couple of the Eagles players a bit short. It's actually Pearce is picking up Barrett. Floriani is matching up on Matty Connell, and Colville is trying to go with Matty Bruin at this stage.
David McCarr, I might have to get your mother to do a bit of knitting during the week because I am freezing up here at this stage.
Just do what I do, Mark. Put on a couple of stones since you retired from playing footy. You won't feel it. As Greenwood. Talk about young Tyros. On the left boot, around the corner, Sicilella. He's quick and effective. He uses the ball pretty well. McGregor, about 70. Chips it forward into Kluzak. One grab, two grab. Got it.
Terrific grab.
Good balance, good vision.
What a McGregor, too. He really punched that ball into the breeze. Put it out in front of Kluzak, who has got very good hands. And he's attacked that ball hard today. And that time he took it with two grabs. But it's been impressive.
Four possessions for Kluzak. From 35 out, directly in front, into a very stiff breeze. It'll take his best kick. He pushes it high. Well, he's gone against the trend of the other fellows who tried to punch it low. This time it's worked. It sits up into the breeze, and the Eagles get another one into the breeze. That's an important kick.
Well, it just seems like both sides working into the breeze, their work rate's tremendous. West Adelaide in that first quarter, they were excellent, but now they just seem to have taken the foot off the pedal a little bit. And the Eagles have worked into the breeze perfectly. That is a great kick. Right into the teeth of the breeze. Look at that. It's a great drop punt, and it did not deviate. So,
an old-fashioned arm wrestle, Mark.
It definitely is. 3-3-21 plays the Eagles. 4-3-27. So a six-point margin for the boys from down on Port Road. That's not the Magpies. That's the Eagles.
Oh!
Nearly lined him up. Nearly took him out of the contest. Quick enough to see how the caught his eye. Pavlik just too quick for his play. Goes to top of the square. Kluzak again, playing in front. Gets his hands on the football. A clash of bodies will occur here. Great eyes for the football was young Greenwood, the young 17-year-old, playing his fourth game. And Tim, watch this.
Well, if Ed Richardson had connected Sicilella here, Tim, he would have cremated him.
Absolutely. I think Sicilella had great vision there just to get his kick away and then pull away.
See, that was going to be a bone-crushing contest. Matthew Pavlik around the corner and a point. So he's kicked two goals, one in an inspiring display in the Eagles forward line.
He's been the target, hasn't he? He's been the one that's created things up there for him. And he's just having such a fantastic year.
He's up against a fairly experienced player there in Miles. But we see other games, David, playing around the state. We see Central 39, South coming back at 31. And North and Sturt, well, North hanging on to that 20-point margin.
That'll be an important one for them after last week's debacle as Dempsey releases Barrett through the midfield. Now, they're doing what the Eagles didn't. They're playing direct, and it's worked for them. Straight down the corridor, and Richardson takes a chest mark.
The one thing West Adelaide have done with the breeze that the Eagles didn't was keep it open. And there was only two players in the forward 50 then, and of course Richardson being one of them.
One of the things we've missed today, Tim, is the state full forward against the state full back. You get your money's worth at Richmond Oval as Richardson, with one goal kicked in the first quarter, kicks with the breeze and he's back and he just turns it around the corner. It just did enough, a real helicopter, but he gets his second. And West Adelaide just pull one back. They're back within a point.
Well, he seems to have the helicopter working because we saw him do it last week as well, and he got 4 points for it, but just seeing an interchange now, looks like young Greenwood coming off. And it looks like Clint Keary, the lad that's been drafted by the Crows, coming back on. He's going to have a run in the middle on the footy, but Westies have got five in there. Get out, son.
So Stewart up against Big Ones, 27 plays 28, so West Adelaide back within 1 point. Again, this time Stewart reads it a bit better. Quickly kicked there by Connell, was smothered. Again, it's picked up. 26 coming around is Chubb. Couldn't get it through. Overrun it was Mellor. Back there is Rogers. Good pressure applied. Unfortunately, the free kick was given away, and we'll come up with a captain in Rogers, who finds Colville. Colville trying to create something, decide to go wide, looking for Pavlik. Three deep Pavlik just crashes through the pack once again. I can't. This is Hugh Green. They can't catch him this afternoon. Disposal's not good, under a fair bit of pressure. DeRosa takes out his opposition player there. Should have been paid a free kick, possibly. Umpire, good umpiring, lets it go.
Sicilella fakes the handball and then drives towards Pavlich. Over that player's head. Can they work it out? Filippo taken high, but the umpire unsighted says it's holding the ball. Well, there'll be a few Eagles fans who won't like that.
Nah, I couldn't see that. He attacked the ball hard, had not much opportunity to get rid of it anyway. Plus, the tackle slipped up to the shoulder.
All depends on your perspective. We had this side of it, the umpire at the other side.
True.
As Andriski releases Barrett. Hasn't Barrett worked hard in the midfield? Oh, Biglin's a big fly, but it falls out the back. He should have brought it forward. Biglin's it didn't. Now it's Matty Connell over the top of the ball, working hard. Gets bustled off it. Clint Keary fights hard for it. Mellor releases the ball. Getting the kick away was Robbie Liebert. Here comes the skipper. Andrew Rogers over the top. Works it out. Nicely done, you Grinnick in the double play. And a short pass out there wide. And Brent Fruin lopes away. The centre-half back drills it in low. And not a good kick.
Yeah, poor disposal there. But that ball just wouldn't sit up for Matty Connell. He was waiting for the one that just sit up a bit. Didn't come to him.
McMahon clears. The kick didn't carry. Biglin's read it. Took the mark. Quickly gets back. Wants to get the ball moving. Over the top there. 51 to Tukuala. Couldn't do much with it. Umpire will come in and ball up. The crowd there, hands in the pocket. The hats are on, the boonies are on, the scarves are around the neck.
I reckon they're tough at Port Adelaide, Tim. Well, I reckon the Port Adelaide fans were bred from West Adelaide fans.
Oh, chance for Bannock. Goes wide. In there will be Pierce. He's been reasonably quiet this afternoon, but he's a quality state player, young Adam Pierce.
See, that's the thing I've probably missed in the lead-up to this game, the high calibre of player we've actually got competing in the one match.
Actually, the standard across the SNFL is excellent, isn't it? And that's why you've got such an even competition. I think even as low down as seventh are on four wins. So it's a very close competition because there is a good sprinkling of good players throughout the whole competition. So I think it's makes for a great series coming up the finals anyway.
McGregor in ruck for the Eagles, thumps it down, wins the tap. The base of the pack, Dempsey just picked that up like a basketball and took off. He is very slick, and you really feel saddened for him that the injury robbed him of his chance with the Crows. Brune forward, Paul a big destroy. Oh. Great roving, the big man inside, and he just lobs for the goal square, and he's at the post.
Unlucky.
He did everything right, didn't he?
Well, he would have been absolutely bragging about that at the West Adelaide Players Disco tomorrow night. But he's picked it up like a rover. Tried to dribble along a la Dacos. Didn't come off.
Scores locked away. 28 apiece. Eagles this time, they have a chance to run it. That's Pierce.
He's the key to their midfield, this fellow, too, isn't he?
Yeah, well, he's had, as you can see there, three marks. And that's his 10th possession. Now kicks towards Culver, one of the smallest players on the ground. Reading it over the top. They're just too tall. It was Ed Richardson. Good mark, going with the flight of the football. Oh, I don't know what Ed's trying to create there. I think maybe bring a bit of rain. The only way you can describe that kick, straight up into the air. Comes out wide. McCarty, wide of Stuhl. Comes up to James. James heads up towards now. Kluzak, it's been exciting in the second quarter. Can spot out the corner of his eye. Player out there, tried to find him, and McGregor couldn't take it. In there again is James. Players dive over the top of the football.
I like Kluzak up forward. He really does attack the ball hard and create something. He's a spark. And if they can keep it open, just him and Filippo perhaps down there and Pavlik lurking, they'll have a good forward setup.
Just wonder how strong that breeze is, because both sides really have had no difficulty scoring into it.
True.
Well, strong, David.
You're good.
Strong players just working very hard, this Eagles side. They have improved their work rate, and that's what it gets down to.
Pierce to Floriani. Sits it up with the breeze. Here comes Pavlich, front position. He read it beautifully. Well, nobody else seemed to get close, and he read it so early. In the prime position, took front of the pack, and it just sat up nicely for him.
Well, he's the only one that went forward to it. Everybody else was sort of jostling for position, and he went forward to it. And Dion Miles, before he realised it was too late, and he had the drop on him.
I guess that's one of the hallmarks of a good player. They read it earlier off the boot than other players, and Pavlich was just right in the right position. He's kicked two goals, won the 17-year-old. 18 goals so far in a short career, and make that 19. He doesn't miss, right through the middle.
Well, we keep saying it every week we see this lad, how much of a talent he is. But when you see things like that, And on the interchange, Mark Stewart's come off, I believe, for Watkins. I think Benny Watkins is going to go into ruck.
He was four deep, Pavlich, and came, weaved through and took the front position.
Like I said, the only one that moved towards a footy and attacked it, everybody else was trying to make position. It was always going to drop short.
He should throw down to Michael Parsons. Michael, I just saw Watkins there. He's chafing it a bit. Just how excited was he to get onto the ground?
Yes, Mark, I heard my name, but the question eluded me. It is still blustery down here as West Adelaide go forward again. But, yeah, Benny Watkins, first run on the ground today. Be interested to see him get his hands on the ball.
Sigalella wide. Whelan, Bannick. There'll be sparks flying between those two as well. Bannick, front position this time. Gets the handball forward. Chubb claimed by Ugrinic. And too high, said the umpire, so it's a free kick. We're 21 minutes into the second quarter. It's a six-point ball game. The Eagles, with Pavich's last goal, have gone a kick ahead. And this contest is really developing beautifully. Chubb, exciting junior from West Adelaide. Biglin's front, and then goes to the back. Mark Strongly relieves a little bit of pressure. He's playing a role very similar to Sean Wren today, deep in defence for the Eagles, but Andriski marks beautifully.
Andriski. Quick kick up forward. Good mark by Symes. Symes turns. The ball just... enough pressure there applied by the Eagles defender. Could force the error up to Pavlich again. And this is going to be a foot race. He's in there again. Good work there by Richardson just to hold his ground and lay it off to DeRosa. DeRosa puts it up. Good kick. Gets it forward and finds Keary. Keary thumps it forward. Over the back was Mellor. Maybe might have given away a free kick. Rogers back to Hall. Hall around the body. He's got a player out wide and Fruin. Now Fruin should take this and run with it. Gets a quick kick forward to Ugrinic. Chance now for Ugrinic just to get players across this side of the ground. Now heads up forward. The back there looked like McGregor couldn't take it. Good work there by Watkins for his first touch. Lays it off to Andriski. Over the back, the fly again by Symes. Couldn't bring it to ground, but nearly kept it in control. The Eagles defence again will clear. It'll be set up to Floriani. Floriani, high ball. Where's Kluzak? He comes out strong again. Should take this, knocks it down to Pavlich. Pavlich inside 50, puts it high. The breeze brings it back. That's his fourth, Tim Juniver. What a quarter of football by the young fella.
Well, the whole Eagles team, their work rate, you wouldn't have known them in the first quarter. They looked like they were asleep, they were flat, they were tired. This quarter, it's the old swap Guernsey trick. They've just worked and worked and worked into the breeze. And Pavlich, he just... reads the thing so well. Kluzak again, I love the way he gets involved. Look at that, he attacks the footy hard. The big Pavlich, that's another good kick. Watch the way that bends around. He is an exceptionally talented
lad. Well, the Eagles
lad.
Forwards are leading their players to the football. Another change has been made down there, David. Dylan comes off and coming on for his first run of the afternoon is Darzanos.
Spiro Darzanos, a speedy Rover wingman. Watkins caught underneath the ball. Biglands wins the tap. Now it's Dempsey on the left boot, turning it around the corner. Here comes Mallow. Geez, just attacking the football and giving West Adelaide every bit of energy that he can give them. Towards Richardson, over that player's head, it falls to the back. Clint Keary on the right boot. Oh, good goal, Keary. He's a clever player, and that's what the Crows saw in him when they recruited him. That was very slick.
Well, West Adelaide, they needed that, I tell you, because they're going to go in half-time probably a little bit down or level, and they won't be pleased after their superb first quarter to set the game up. Keary gets this goal, but it really is going to be a disappointing quarter, and at half-time, Michael Taylor will be trying to rev him up once again to try and have a very important third quarter into the breeze.
5-4 play, 6-4, a six-point ball game. The Eagles still in front. Good bounce. Chaffer Watkins to take it uncontested. Just trying to put it down Dempsey's throat. Couldn't quite find it. Coming up hard with it was Whelan. He was tackled well. And the umpire will come in and put it down once again to start proceedings. Watkins up against Biglands. Similar height. Watkins maybe just with a slight advantage as far as the weight concerned. Watkins with a long sleeve jumper on. Biglands, well, they both put it down or towards us in the direction of the same player there. Mellor comes out, he's pushed from behind. Coming up there, good work by Lee. Lee quickly forward. Adam Richardson comes out hard, should take this, try to keep it. He does well with that football. Hall was set up. The umpire will come in, believes it was held to. He couldn't be happy there. Kiri demanding that the umpire blow his whistle and pay the free kick.
Richardson worked hard to try and bring that ball back in. Not sure that it would be a better option necessarily just to let it go out and reset the Rucks and Rovers and look for a set play. So you get a call from behind and there's another Hardy fan enjoying the football. It's a good crowd here at Richmond Oval, but it is very cold. We're almost 26 minutes into the second quarter at Richmond Oval. The Eagles lead by 6 points. As the siren sounds, Tim, you'd have to say that West Adelaide won the first quarter, the Eagles won the second quarter, and at halftime, it's a real arm wrestle as we go into the second half.
Both coaches would have been very pleased with their quarters into the breeze, but extremely disappointed going with it. Whether they're not using it properly, whether they're not keeping it open. I mean, I thought Westies did keep their forward line open in that occasion, but their midfield didn't get hold of the ball. It was the Eagles' midfield that started to dominate, started to work it through, get it up to guys like Pavlik, who you see on your screen there. Kluzek was alive and exciting up there, and they just created options, and their work rate was tremendous. So both coaches are going to go into halftime fairly well puzzled by their quarters with the breeze.
So at halftime here at Richmond Oval, it's West Adelaide 5-4, the Eagles are 6-4. It's a six-point ball game. You're watching the SANFL live and exclusive to ABC Sport.